You know, the newspapers really started because merchants wanted to know what prices were in different places, and they start in port cities very much so, and they're not telling you what happened in that particular community because people know that because they're talking to everyone else. But what they will do is give news from other places. And, you know, Boston, in the early part of the 18th century, a post road set up between Boston and New York. You know, there's a pretty active shipping route between Boston and New York by sea, but the post road goes from Boston to New York and allows for the transmission of news, and then a road through New Jersey to connect New York with Philadelphia. It requires going over a few ferries, and then there's a road from Philadelphia south to Maryland. You can get to Virginia, and after that, things get very sketchy. But the Boston Post Road becomes a major artery for transmission of news. And by the early 1760s, 1770s, the Sons of Liberty realize the importance of having this as a communication network. And Paul Revere really becomes one of the messengers they will send along the road. But the newspapers also circulate by way of the Post Road and will be read in taverns. They're not meant for someone to read early in the morning before they go to work. They're read in taverns or coffee shops, as people will have a pile of newspapers from different places as they're trying to find the news from different places. And circulating in this way as a public thing, you're reading this newspaper with a group of guys in a tavern or a group of people in a coffee house, or sometimes the newspapers will be posted on a town bulletin board. It's a way of spreading news or communicating. And it's a novel innovation in the 18th century, and it does create a network of communication. It really is what's going to create a national polity or a national identity during and after the Revolution.